This is the morning after a truce. Fallen bodies on the streets of Kiev. Protesters confronting security services who respond with live ammunition. Here, a CNN photographer catches the moment when a group of medics is seen helping a man lying on the ground. There is a shot. One medic falls to the ground and tries to crawl away. We don't know if he survived. The casualties climb quickly. Some are carried to a nearby hotel.
Here in this building, the protesters set up an emergency medical clinic. This is where some of the very first casualties were brought. They say three people were still alive when they were first brought here. But the efforts of the medical teams here have not been enough to save the lives of at least these 11 people who now lie on the marble floor of this hotel lobby.
Dr. Olga Bogomolets, the head of the medical team, says they had little chance of surviving their injuries.
They were killed by snipers directly with the metal bullets, with guns, shooting directly to heart, eyes, shooted for death.
Later, a sheet conceals the bodies while they are identified by family. Anton says he did his best to clean the bodies for them.
I'm cleaning blood with the floor and I'm crying because this is really, really hard for me. I can't.
The confrontation started just after dawn. A barrage of stones, fireworks, Molotov cocktails. Hundreds of protesters spread along the barricades on Independence Square, throwing whatever they could get their hands on. They targeted lines of security forces a short distance away, standing beyond the range of rocks and bottles. But we also saw one man firing a shotgun. We don't know what he was using for ammunition. These people had no faith in the government declared ceasefire. The president said no more violence.
No. The president only says, they say all times.
This is the hardcore element of the protest crowd, wearing homemade body armor, carrying shields, those prepared to take the fight directly to the security services. Shortly after, those officers received an order to pull back, once again giving up the square to the opposition. But some of the protesters pursued them through the streets. The response? Gunfire. The result? More blood and death in Kiev. Phil Black, CNN, Kiev.